side. And that point, so
how do they prep you?
They say when you go up, you're gonna go like this, and you're gonna go like this, and I'm gonna push you, and when I tap you, you can go like this, and that's all they say.
Oh my god.
So how often
you look so jacked up.
It's so the adrenaline is crazy. What was your question?
So how often does this guy who's reading you down with him, how often does he do this?
He's probably done it for at least like 6 years. Probably. Yeah, one
jumping
guy.
It's
crazy, dude. This
that's
stuff,
awesome.
It's nuts. One of the guys apparently did what was it? 16,000 jumps in 6 years, which seems literally impossible,
what?
But like you'd have to do like 100 every single day, 365 days a year. Which is
cool. Who's on the scooter? Ferreira.
Where is Ferreira?
Oh, yeah.
Is that Ferreira on the scooter in the middle of the field?
I think he's out for the season.
Is he really?
Yeah, it sucks.
Is he upset? Can you talk to him? He doesn't really get upset. He's always kind of upset.
I mean, he's definitely upset, but he just doesn't show it, really.
Yeah, he's just kind
of
going to be disappointed.
We have the rankings for MIA.
Okay, where's Joe Duggan?
Do you have all the rankings? Did you get the scores?
Oh,
yeah.
Joe.
You got the scores, okay. So we are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Wow.
Nice. 1 and 3 in the MIA.
And we're both 7 and 4. We're both. So I just go with 7 and 4 like it's easy. And then.
Ooh! That ball went into the crowd. Hot.
I know.
I fed like 7 foot, probably 7 or 8 foot carpet in Key West. It was so cool.
Oh my word.
What is it?
Carpet.
What?
Those
dude, that is crazy.
They're bigger than you.
Oh my god.
They're bigger than you.
Are they like the silverfish that like dart?
Because
those things are crazy.
Oh my gosh.
Andrew, my sister, and that's me feeding them.
Oh my gosh.
That's, and then there are nurse sharks as well.
The nurse sharks scare me.
Nurse sharks are sick.
But you know
that's
what?
That's so cool.
I want
that's
to
so
get, and wait till the end of the story, I want to get bitten by a nurse shark because I think it would make the coolest scar ever. Like,
that
just
would
in my arm, like, chomp chomp. You know what I mean? Like, just a little, like, I just think it'd be so cool.
No, a nurse shark?
Until it rips
nurse
your shirt red.
Oh, holy
nurse
god, that is the problem,
cool.
But I want just one small chomp.
No, this story.
Quick,
this story.
I want the story of getting bitten by a nurse shark so badly. I've literally always said that.
Yeah, we fed those. And then,
and just saying, Zach Hayashi is. Oh, you have him there, face off. Yeah. It's just confusing because of that, but we're good.
We also went to a sea turtle concert. That was super cool. But it was also like.
Sad to see the
sea yeah, it was. It was very hard to see the.
Are sea turtles easy to mend? Because their shells are ruined. They have big issues, right?
Well, they definitely
yeah.
have to stay in like 6 years.
Yeah. Can you give a sea turtle a new shell?
No.
You can probably make like. Can you make like silicone?
Like
yeah,
but
they
it
use,
is not the same.
Oh,
they
you
use,
cover it with silicone.
They use
or something like that. Probably.
They'll use like epoxy and like epoxy it together
sense.
And like use like metal stuff to like try and bring it together and let it heal.
Yeah.
Hey, where did you guys find this CD?
Dude, I have no idea. This is.
This is ours from 2012.
No. But,
yeah.
No, I don't know. I think it's probably, there's probably one CD. It probably sits right there, and it probably goes in every time
it's
a game. So
the
it's not surprising.
The CD, I don't think, the CD player, I don't think works anymore. It's
yeah.
a playlist on some, it's, I don't, what was his name? What's the guy's name?
It's true, it's Warm-Up. That is so weird. That is almost identical to the songs that we had
really?
10 years ago.
Gotcha.
Times never change.
That is weird.
I mean,
well, he definitely lost his...
It seems like the most miserable, like...
Yeah, it's
it seems
really
like the
bad.
Most miserable thing ever. I'm so upset for him. I know, like...
There's a kid.
I'm so upset for him.
Yeah, it's rude.
What's his name? I don't remember his name. I was playing basketball with him today. Like, literally... An hour ago, I was with him. He said he lost his high point scholarship.
Yeah, he definitely did. it kind of sucks.
Welcome everyone to the live stream tonight. We have varsity lacrosse between Calvert Hall Cardinals and the McDonough Eagles. This should be a pretty solid matchup between these two teams. Very evenly matched, and this is a perfect night. You can't ask for anything more than this. About 70 degrees here in Towson, Maryland. No breeze and just partly cloudy out. It's just a beautiful, beautiful night for some competitive high school lacrosse. So we are getting underway here now and rising for the national anthem. So we'll be back after that is done. And now at the conclusion of the national anthem, we are about ready to get underway here tonight. Merz, you got any insights on today's game?
Yeah, we got a really great matchup. Both teams coming into this game at 7-4. Calvert Hall coming off an unfortunate loss to John Carroll the other day, 8-7, and McDonough coming off their loss to St. Mary's, 7-6. But going to be a great game today. Calvert Hall being led by their star attackman and now named Under Armour All-American Truett Sunderland. And on the other side for the Eagles, McCabe Millen at attack, the number one recruit and player in the class of 2023. So it's going to be a really good matchup today, and I'm really excited to see what both these teams have in store for us tonight.
Yeah, so Calvert Hall starting lineup. We have the freshman Brady Stengel in goal, J.K. Kelly, Brad Johnson, and Luke McAuliffe at defense. We have Jordan Beck on defense as well. We have Jackson Strickland at faceoff, Donnie Lewis on the wing. And then for our attack, we have Truett Sunderland, Jordan Ray, and it looks like Luke Whalen for the Cardinals here.
Yeah, first line midfield coming in now for Calvert Hall. Jordan Reagan tracked down a D-middy there. Good win there off the faceoff for Calvert Hall. Donovan Lewis getting a ground ball and getting the first possession for this Calvert Hall offense. Davis Provost wearing number 22 today, his original number.
Sunderland's shot going to go wide.
Little bit of a change here on this offense. They're going to have Luke Whalen for Calvert Hall at lefty attack, and Davis Provost is going to move up to midfield.
A nice move from Steele. Steele cannot get it to go. And it's going to stay with Calvert Hall.
Very close shot there by Steele.
And here's Hoddle. Hoddle going to take it. Pass to Ray. Another pass over to Whalen. And they're going to reset it. 20 on the shot clock. A little bit of miscommunication there. And there's a, looks like an offsides. And it's going to be McDonough ball.
Yeah, Luke Miller getting the ground ball for McDonough. We're going to see their first starting line. Hugh Brown along with Matt McMillan. And number 36, Bogue Hahn.
Here's Hahn. Donnie Lewis in at D-mid against Hahn.
Coverall's got Wyatt Hoddle stuck on defense right now. We know he can play a great D-mid when he needs to.
And shot, that's a goal. Number 9, McCabe Millen will get the first goal of the evening.
Yeah, it was a great right-to-left split dodge by Millen and an on-the-run overhand shot going right past Calverall's goalie. As we said, Calverall's got a new goalie in the freshman, Brady Stangle. Going to get a lot of reps this season, near the end of the season, and they're going to look to him to help this defense and carry this defense.
It's going to be a false start against Johnson. And it will be Eagles ball.
Yeah, Calverall's got to watch out for those turnovers there. Don't want to give up easy turnovers. As Noah Brannick and Donovan Lewis head in for D-Mitty for Calverhall, along with Hunter Bowen at LSM. Hunter Bowen moving up to LSM for this game. Usually a down low defender, but we know he can play a really great long stick midfielder as well.
And forgot to introduce ourselves. I'm Brendan Trentler alongside Ethan Mears, the start of the game. Just excited to get this one underway. Forgot to put that in there. Here's Millen.
Great defense by J.K. Kelly there against that number one recruit. Good defense here by Donovan.
It's
going to
go off the post, and it's going to reset the shot clock. And McDonough will keep possession of the ball. Hahn out there to save the offensive possession.
Noah Brannick stuck behind cage right now at D-mid.
He's playing physical. And here's Kelly now against Millen. It's a good matchup.
Great slide.
And Millen loses his stick, and it's picked up by Beck. Beck trying to get out. And Kelly's in a little bit of trouble. He gets out. And Calvert Hall is going to get this clear off. Brannick's going to take it over. And what a defensive possession for Calvert Hall.
Yeah, that was a great defensive segment for Calvert Hall. J.K. Kelly locking down his offensive player, and then Jordan Beck coming in with a great slide to cause the turnover there, and a great ground ball by the Syracuse commit. Good job by both Kelly and Beck to communicate there and get that ball out of harm's way and onto the offensive side for this Calvert Hall team.
And shot from Ray, saved by Anthony Wilson, the goalie, and it's given away. And it'll be Calvert Hall. Oh, no, sorry. It stays McDonough ball. So it must have been a tip or something.
Yeah, it could have been a tip there. Hard to tell. But, yeah, great save by Wilson, the senior, in cage for the Eagles. But a little bit of an errant pass there. Got lucky getting that ball back for the McDonough team. Jordan Ray stuck at D-mid right now. Another great defender when he has to be a defender for this Calvert Hall team.
Zoom out a little bit. You don't need to be so far in. Yeah, that's perfect. Right there. You don't even have to move it. You can just leave it there.
And that's a goal for McDonough. for number 33, Jack Rayleigh.
Yeah, Matt McMillan dodging to his left hand, getting a pass inside, seeing the cutting Rayleigh, and Rayleigh getting a doorstep or shot on the doorstep and getting that goal. McDonough up 2-0 now, and Jackson Strickland versus Zach Hayashi right now at the faceoff, and Jackson's going to push it forward and get the ground ball on the win.
Cavadal need to capitalize on their offensive possessions.
Been having trouble lately. Have had a good amount of offensive possessions and chances right now, but just couldn't stick it in the back of the cage. And we see this new midfield line, Kyle Baxo having a go right now. The junior heading to Providence.
And well, that's a shot from Provost, and he'll get it to go. What a sidearm shot from Davis Provost to put Calvert Hall on the board. That's assisted from Kyle Baxo.
Yeah, that is a great shot by Provost. A lefty underhand shot there from deep with not much of an angle around the defender. And as we said, that good assist there, getting the defense moving by Kyle Baxo. Good start for Calvert Hall, and they're going to need to keep that up today, keep that energy going, as Zach Hayashi is going to get a false start for McDonough, and Calvert Hall is going to get this ball back.
So Calvert Hall able to get the ball after the McDonough mistake. So let's see what they're able to do on this offensive possession. Coming off the goal from Provost, they're going to go back to the first midi line. They got EJ Vasile, Jordan Ray, Truett Sunderland, Davis Provost, Nick Steele, all in there.
Got two Virginia commits going at it right now. Truett Sunderland and Malachi Jones, both top senior players in the class of 2022, both headed to Virginia. Gonna be no call there on that pick, as Jordan Ray just misses with that underhand shot and that pass coming from Wyatt Hoddle.
So 30 seconds on the shot clock, and Hoddle gonna take a rip, save from Wilson, and they're gonna get a fresh 60. So 5:45 left to go here in the first quarter of action. McDonough Eagles up 2-1 over Calvert Hall. Calvert Hall with the ball now, trying to work it around. McDonough playing pressure defense and really sticking out. Here's Sunderland. Sunderland's shot saved from Wilson. And now McDonough on the break.
Calvert Hall minis are really going to have to work to get back in the hole here.
And that's a goal for McMillan as he gets right through. So McCabe Millen will get his second of the evening.
Yeah, Calvert Hall late to get back in the hole there. And McDonough did a good job of pushing that transition and getting the ball to their best player and letting him have a go at his defender and getting a goal there. McDonough up 3-1 now on Calvert Hall. Calvert Hall's really going to have to make these faceoffs essential and really capitalize on these offensive possessions. It was a good try there by Truett Sunderland, breaking through the defender, but great save by Anthony Wilson there.
Calvert Hall won the last three faceoffs and was able to get one to go, but this being their third offensive possession after the faceoff win.
And now we are seeing Ryan Botek in on the midfield line along with Josh Nagy on offense. Josh Nagy, usually a D-middy, playing some offense tonight, as that shot by Baxo is saved by Wilson.
McDonough just holding it up at the top, trying to set up their offense, get all of their middies. An attack set. And here comes the Eagles. Here's Millen. McCabe Millen trying to go for his hat trick. That ball's poked out by Kelly. He can't scoop it up. Shot to the helmet, and they're going to get Kelly flagged.
Yeah, unfortunate there. It was a great cause turnover by J.K. Kelly. Couldn't get up the ground ball, and McMillan getting that loose ball and getting, like we said, a slash to the helmet there. And Kelly's going to head to the penalty box in a moment.
Two, one, and it is going to be, they're going to call that a goal.
And the coaches on the Calvert Hall side are not happy with that decision. Coach Mulford not having any of that with the refs.
That was Furley. Okay. So goal scored by Ben Furley, the sophomore, with no time left. And Calvert Hall coaches and fans not happy about that one.
Yeah, this is a big rivalry game tonight, and there's going to be a lot of emotions in this game. But the coaches on the Calvert Hall side not happy with that call by the refs, thinking that time expired before that goal went in the back of the net. But Calvert Hall is going to talk it over and regroup and try and get this Calvert Hall offense going after this timeout. And we are back out of the timeout. The play before, Ben Furley for McDonough, the sophomore, getting a buzzer beater shot with only 2 seconds left on the shot clock. Questionable call, but they're going to count the goal there. And Calvert Hall still going to be man down on this faceoff. The goal did not wipe away that penalty. And Jackson Strickland with another faceoff win. Jackson doing a great job at the X right now for the Cardinals. A little bit of a dangerous pass there by Stengel, but Bowen doing a great job to get that out of there. Ori Amiri now in at defense. And it's going to just get over.
Just get over. So 3 minutes left to go. Calvert Hall down 4-1. To McDonough, and they're trying to capitalize on this possession. And every possession counts in a game this close. And Calvert Hall trying to use theirs a little bit more efficiently, as they've only had one goal in the first 10 minutes, 9.5 minutes of this evening. E.J. Vasile comes on, and now Calvert Hall is all even.
And J.K. Kelly's going to head back on defense for Calvert Hall.
Here comes Sunderland. Sunderland shot off the mark.
Calvert Hall
is there.
Calvert Hall getting really close with their shots, just aren't able to stick any in the back of the cage right now. Having a bunch of opportunities.
And Ray's shot is, I believe it was saved.
And Malachi Jones is going to pick up that ground ball for the Eagles. And Wilson's going to carry that ball up now.
And they have 6 seconds to get this over. And they will get it over. And here's Han. Han's on the other side of that pass. So he gets it. And now McMillan's going to hold it up.
Just too many M's and Nicks. It's just annoying.
Here's Brown.
Donovan Lewis with good defense there against Brown.
Trying to make a move. And that's a shot. No goal. Over the net. One minute to go in the first quarter here at Calvert Hall. And there's a save from Stengel, his first of the night. And now Donnie Lewis on the break for Calvert Hall. Lewis trying to look. He's going to take it himself. And that's a goal for Donnie Lewis. And cuts it to two. Donnie Lewis with coast-to-coast goal for Calvert Hall.
What a great job. Both ends of the field for Calvert Hall. Stengel with his first save of the game so far. Good to see from that from the freshman in the cage. And a great job by Donovan Lewis getting a goal for Calvert Hall. Saw an opening in that transition and carried it all the way into the back of the cage. And that brings a lot of life to this Calvert Hall team and this Calvert Hall fan base as well. And as we said, that cuts the lead to two with 42.7 seconds left to go in this first quarter between McDonough and Calvert Hall.
There's a little contact to the helmet. No call.
It's a good ground ball by Millen there.
And they're going to hold it up. Hahn's going to take his time.
Evan Huffman in now at D-Mitty with Noah Brannick for Calvert Hall with 17 seconds to go. And Furley's going to have a go at Bowen. And a slide there by Evan Huffman.
So five to go. They're going to pass it on the doorstep. And that's a goal. What a find for McKay Millen to Luke Miller.
Yeah, that was a great vision by Millen there. Seeing his cutting attackman, Miller, and Miller getting that goal on the doorstep. And it is now a three-goal lead for McDonough, and they are up 5-2 with a little over 2 seconds to go in this first quarter.
So that will do it for first quarter action here at Kelly Field. Calvert Hall down 5-2 to the McDonough Eagles. And we'll be back for the second quarter.
We are back for second quarter action between Calvert Hall and McDonough. Jackson Strickland going up against Zach Haishi right now at the faceoff, as Jackson will push it out to Noah Brannick, and that would be an arid pass. Truett Sunderling going to try and save it. Nick Steele tried to keep it in bounds, and they're going to give the ball to McDonough.
So McDonough now with possession. Wilson getting hit by Provost. He takes it, and they get it over half field. Marsh on that far side in trouble. He gets it off to Millen, and McCabe Millen gets out of it, and he's going to take it at goal. And he tries to find Miller. That ball is on ground.
Great.
And out comes Stengel. Brady Stengel came all the way out of net over to the near sideline.
Great effort by Stengel there. It's going to stay McDonough ball. And they are going to set up their offense here with their starting midfield line. Millen doing a good job of getting out of that double team. Not easy when you're going up against two top-tier defenders in J.K. Kelly and Bradley Johnson.
Both of these teams doing an excellent job with penalties. As there was a potential one there from Brannick.
Great
steal.
And
that's intercepted by Johnson. Johnson takes it over half field, and he's going to hold it up for support.
Great job by Johnson. And no Brannick looking for a quick pass inside. And Steele's going to get a goal. Steele cutting the lead now to 2. And great job there by Noah Brannick to see a cut in Nick Steele. And good job by the Calvert Hall offense to see the open window of opportunity there and get another goal in the back of the net.
And Bradley Johnson starting that whole play by getting that intercepting the ball, getting it out, waiting for support from Noah Brannick, and cuts the lead to 2 with 10 minutes to go left in the second period.
Yeah, that brought some life back into this Calvert Hall team, and got to keep just capitalizing on these offensive possessions that they're given.
That's a shot saved. There was a big thud coming from Wilson.
Yeah, you can see him grabbing his hip. That might have hurt a little bit. Shot right to the inner hip there, coming from what looked like Nick Steele. And Brendan Kemsky is now going to come in at D middy with Evan Huffman. Brendan Kemsky, the junior for Calvert Hall, doing a great job on Hugh Brown there.
And that pass, I think it was a shot, deflected. And it will stay Calvert Hall ball with 47 seconds left to go.
Both teams running a similar 3-1-3 offense here. Interesting to see the two teams and how they play this. Great defense by J.K. Kelly. A great save by the freshman, Brady Stengel. That's another save for him. A little bit of a risky pass there.
And a beautiful pass from Kelly. And Calvert Hall gets it over. And Evan Huffman gets that ball over midfield for the Cardinals.
Yeah, good job by Luke McAuliffe to get that ball over to Evan Huffman, as Davis Provost going to have a go here. Gonna lose the ball, but hang on to it.
Not sure how he stayed with that. Very nice play from Provost. Truett Sunderland now. Getting to crease, getting tripped up, and they're going to call a crease violation against Sunderland.
We're going to see this matchup a lot tonight on both ends. J.K. Kelly going against McCabe Millen, and Risky here right now. Bradley Johnson going on Malachi Jones. But like I was saying, and then Malachi Jones versus Truett Sunderland on the other end. Really close there. Jones doing a good job hanging on to that ball.
Here's Millen. Here's Furley finding Millen. McCabe Millen. He's going to get a shot, and that's off target. And Lewis is going to get over there, and Cavadall receives possession after the McCabe Millen miss.
You see that that speed by Donovan Lewis. Great effort getting to the ball there and giving Cavadall an extra possession. Good pass from Stengel to Hoddle. And we're seeing more of Josh Nagy playing offense tonight. And we're going to see Cody Collier coming in for the first time tonight as well for Cavadall. And alongside them will be Ryan Botek on the midfield line. We know that Nagy can play some offense. A dual threat for this team.
And Nagy playing center back for the varsity team for soccer. He has that quickness and the agility that both an offensive and defensive player for lacrosse needs.
And he's definitely got that championship mentality. Yeah.
And that pass from Provost gonna be over the heads of Ryan Botek and Nick Steele. So it will be McDonald ball with 6 minutes to go in the first half. And Wilson just gonna walk it up here.
And Evan Hoffman now in at D mid, and Bradley Johnson at LSM, and Josh Nagy will stay in on defense.
And a timeout called.
Coach Kelly not happy with how this Cavadall team's playing right now. Really want them to regroup and figure out what's going on right now so that they can hopefully get something going for this team and give some life back into this Cavadall offense.
Back with 5:38 left to go in here in the second half. McDonough up 5-3 over the Cavadall Cardinals on a beautiful Friday night.
Games of the week, as we got the turnover here by Luke McAuliffe, and a great hockey scrape there by Luke McAuliffe. And he's going to try and take it to the goal here possibly, but he's going to play it safe and get it off to Nick Steele. And Cavadall doing a great job on defense there. Great effort by Luke McAuliffe, the senior heading to Lehigh. And we're going to see the starting lineup on midfield for Calvert Hall come back. As I was saying, big game tonight. Looking like we got the Varsity Sports Network with their camera crew here tonight taping this game.
And Hoddle shot saved by Wilson. And Wilson's up to four saves. McDonough now with possession, 4 minutes left to go. 50 seconds on the shot clock. And I do apologize for just a moment there. We did have a connection error, so the stream did go out for just a second. So I apologize. And EJ Vasile's stick broke.
Good pickup by Noah Brannick there. Like Trentler said, EJ Vasile breaking his stick there. He's giving a good effort on defense, not usually stuck in that defensive midi position. And Calvert Hall back on offense, looking to capitalize on this possession.
Cavardall's first midi line in for these final 3 minutes with Ray Hoddle. And Ray going to take it at goal. Another save from Wilson. Anthony Wilson coming up. Huge. And shot from Millen saved by Stengel. Both goalies having a phenomenal night. And that's a ground ball for Hoddle. Over to Ray, and Cavadal gonna get it over half.
Yeah, two fantastic saves by both goalies as Calvert Hall is gonna get a timeout here. Anthony Wilson starting off the game has just been playing really well in the cage, and it was a little bit of a slow start, but Stengel's been just stellar in the cage since the beginning of the second quarter. So we'll be right back after this timeout.
Back for the last 2 minutes, 11 seconds in the first half. McDonough up 5-3 over Calvert Hall. Calvert Hall with possession, 60 on the shot clock. And Sunderland going to take it. Provost trying to get inside. Oh, what a pass inside to Ray. Little bit of stumbling. Somehow Ray.
Great ground ball by Jordan Ray there to keep that possession alive.
Hoddle gonna take it inside. Hoddle, his shot deflected out of bounds.
Yeah, it looks like it hit off the post there.
Yeah, I think so. I think it hit off two posts. I think it hit off the lacrosse post, and I think it hit off the field goal, actually, and came over to the Cavadal sideline. Sunderland's pass. Vasil, his shot off the mark. Pushed it a little right. And now Sunderland gonna use his speed to try and make something happen. Hoddle gets on the right hand and hit his shot off the crossbar.
And Jordan Ray is gonna try and get this ball, but it's gonna be picked up by AJ Marsh here for McDonough. Great defense by JK Kelly.
And this is a matchup that we've seen all night. We have McCabe Millen and J.K. Kelly just going at it. And McDonough calls a timeout with 53 seconds left to go.
Yeah, they're going to try and set up a good offense to get another goal, hopefully. But Calvert Hall showing that they're still in this. And still a close game, only a two-goal game, but showing that they're ready to let the ball go and let it fly. And we will be right back out of this timeout.
Back out of the McDonough timeout. They're up 5-3 still with 50.
Just for one moment, as we just had a little bit of technical difficulty, but we are back in full swing. McDonough gonna look to set up a play here in the last remaining seconds of this game, or of this second quarter, and get a goal before halftime.
And no need to worry about shot clock, is there's still there's a 10 second differential between the two. Shot clock at 35, game clock at 25.
Calvert Hall is gonna have to look to stay tight on defense here and not give any openings.
You have to be on lookout for Millen.
Especially when you have either Millen with an errant shot there, or
pass gonna be dropped, and a pass inside gonna go nowhere for McDonough, and that will conclude the first half here at Calvert Hall. So a very eventful second quarter, and you know, McDonough scoring no goals in that second quarter. So we'll see how they're able to bounce back from that.
And good to see how Brady Stengel has been playing for most of this game for Calvert Hall. The freshman getting a lot more reps and really trying to fill in this spot at goalie. Doing a really good job tonight. And if Calvert Hall can just keep up these offensive possessions and getting offensive possessions going, then it could be a totally different game in the second half. But going to be a good second half, and we will see you back for the third quarter. And we are back for second half action between Calvert Hall Cardinals and the McDonough Eagles. Jackson Strickland for Calvert Hall going up against number 28 for McDonough, Paul McLucas. And Calvert Hall is going to get the first face-off win of this second half. And Calvert Hall is going to look to pick up right where they left off from the first half and get this offense going, because they've been having a lot of success late in the first quarter and second quarter. And not going to call a trip there on McDonough, as Provost maybe fell from his running through the two defenders there. And it's going to be a turnover. And McDonough will look to clear the ball up.
Oh, and Vasile gets the check.
Great ground ball by JK.
Calvert Hall now in possession.
Truett Sunderland did a good job hanging on to that arid pass.
That was a tough one to scoop up, and Truett was able to do it. And here's Provost. Provost taking a shot, rips it, and goes off crossbar once again for Calvert Hall, their second of the evening.
Good to see Calvert Hall feeling comfortable with these shots, though. They're getting them on cage, as Malachi Jones with a fancy check there, causing a turnover. And that pass is going to be lost in the air, and
I don't think it's going to be. Can McAuliffe save it? No. Calvert Hall was the only goal in the second quarter, only scoring one goal. So this is a very, very defensive game from both sides, and that's, you know, defense is going to win these games, and both sides doing a phenomenal job on the defensive side. K. Millen unable to get inside. And a shot. It's going to be a goal by Matt McMillan for McDonough. And that was a solo goal for McMillan.
Yeah. Unlucky for Calvert Hall. Maybe a bit of a late slide there, miscommunication, but McMillan having a go at Donovan Lewis, and an on-the-run lefty shot to the offside hip of Stangle. Hard one to save, and the lead is now back to 3. McDonough up 6-3 now. Zach Hayashi back at the faceoff for McDonough, and Calvert Hall is going to keep Jackson Strickland in.
Strickland trying to get that ball loose. No. Does not happen. And McDonough with the faceoff win. And that's a shot. That's a save for Stangle. And that'll be his fifth.
First line midfield back on for Calvert Hall. They're going to get an offensive possession here.
And there's a shot from Ray. Does not get it to go.
EJ Vasile coming in now. The Lehigh commit. Jordan Ray thinking about pulling it there, but decides to pass it and move the ball on offense.
Calvert Hall keeping this ball in motion. Ray going to try and make something happen. Puts it over to Hoddle. Hoddle from distance and going to be stay. It's going to stay Calvert Hall ball with 17 left to go on the shot clock with 8:06 left in the third quarter.
Yeah, we're seeing a lot of deep shots from Calvert Hall. That one coming from Wyatt Hoddle outside 15.
And Vasile hesitating to pull the trigger. He has to now. 4-3, and that'll be saved by Wilson. I think that pass from Vasile was directed towards Steele on the crease, but was just off the mark. That would have been tough for Steele to get that off.
Hugh Brown with the ball now. Senior for McDonough heading to Loyola. Going against Donovan Lewis.
Tip. Well, that ball is tipped from Lewis. Great defense from McAuliffe to try and poke it free. And just riding Brown all the way up. Here's Matt McMillan.
Great defense coming from Luke McAuliffe. Big pick there. Possibly a moving pick on McDonough, but they're not going to call that, and it's going to stay Eagles possession.
And I think that's their second one tonight.
Yeah,
of a close call to being a moving screen. And McMillan cannot get his second goal. His shot right. Miller's pass cannot be caught on the crease. Here's Millen.
Great defense from J.K. Kelly.
And what a shot from Millen. McCabe Millen with his third goal of the evening and gives McDonough a 4-goal lead.
Yeah, that was a very impressive move. McMillan capitalized on that slip from Kelly. Kelly playing great defense, and then Millen getting some space and getting that jump shot in the back of the cage. Great goal from Millen as Jackson Strickland had the ball for a second for Calvert Hall, and Johnny Cool, the Ohio State commit for McDonough, is going to pick it up. Another loose ball and great ground ball from Truett Sunderland, the Under Armour All-American, showing his skill, but they're going to have that call going against Jackson Strickland. An illegal hit, it looks like.
I thought that might have been a flag. That was a big hit from Strickland.
Yeah, this is a big rivalry game. There's a lot of emotions, a lot of tension between these two teams, and it'll be crucial that both teams keep their heads and make sure to play sound defense and not get sloppy, because you don't want to cause turnovers that you can prevent.
And always a chance of frustration from any player out here. A lot of chirping on the field. Another save from Stengel. And Huffman gets it over to Johnson. Johnson passes over to Sunderland. No good. And another save for Anthony Wilson.
Anthony Wilson having a really great night in the cage. It was a good catch from Evan Hoffman on the clear, and then good look by Bradley Johnson to get it to the cutting true at Sunderland. But Wilson with a save as McDonough's going to get called for an offsides. And Noah Brannick's going to look to clear up the field. And this first line midfield for Calvert Hall. Back on the field.
Provost tries to get inside. Great defense from Marsh. And Jordan Ray with the shot. Ray, no good. Another shot from Steele, and they just cannot get it to go.
You can see there's a lot of frustration on this Calvert Hall bench. Coach Kelly calling a timeout, not happy with how this team is playing. Getting openings in the goal and on the offensive possessions, the Cardinals have those, but just unlucky with their shots. And they're going to try and regroup here, and we'll be right back after this timeout.
Back out of the Calvert Hall timeout. McDonough with the ball in the right corner, closest to us. It's brought up by Jones. Over to Marsh.
We are back to normal with our broadcast as McCabe Millen's gonna keep the ball here.
Calvert Hall coach is complaining about an offsides as tough to see, and there's been a couple of those instances where these coaches have gotten a little heated tonight. And that ball is loose and cannot be scooped up by McAuliffe, and it will stay at McDonough ball with 26 seconds left to go.
Good effort from McAuliffe, just maybe raked the ball out a little too hard, and it's going to stay McDonough possession, as we said.
10 seconds left to go. Have to get something going. Looking for a pass, maybe. Great defense from Lewis, and shot is not going to get off.
That is a great sign from this Calvert Hall defense, locking down the McDonough offense and causing that shot clock violation. And Coverall is going to look to clear the ball up the field. Luke McAuliffe with the ball at the moment. He's going to use his legs and try and get over the midfield line. But we'll be turned around and we'll get a penalty and the ball over the midfield line. Great effort from Luke McAuliffe.
And that penalty will be on Luke Miller. And shot no good from Provost. And we'll see how long this penalty will be.
Very few penalties in this game today. Only two so far.
Yeah, this is the second one.
One on each team. And we're going to finally get to see this great. Calver Hall, man down. Man up offense. Or man up, excuse me. With a little bit of a change. Ryan Botek at the point for Calver Hall's man up offense. Along with Jordan Ray, EJ Vasile, Wyatt Hoddle, Davis Provost, and Truett Sunderland.
And I think Botek taking the spot of Luke Whalen. Cabral moving the ball very quickly. Again, just trying to find that open man. And it was a minute penalty. And that penalty release at 55 seconds. And a goal from Wyatt Hoddle. Shut with 1 minute, 27 seconds left to go. And Hoddle with his first goal tonight.
And that brings a lot of energy back to this Calvert Hall team. Wyatt Hoddle, great fake move there with that face dodge. Faked the shot and then pulled it into his chest in that goal on the run. And the Richmond commit, the junior, getting this Calvert Hall team hyped up, as well as this Calvert Hall student section. Big whiteout theme today.
A big hit. And now ball in the stick of Millen. And he will bring it out. Strickland, our only faceoff guy for Calvert Hall tonight, and has been doing fairly well, I think over 50%
for sure.
Efficiency.
He's been dominating at the X tonight. Do have a couple other face-off guys. Ben Cuomo, the freshman, and MJ Davis as well, one of the other primary face-off guys. But having a lot of success, not really needing to change much at the face-off X right now. And in terms of injuries, Thomas Strong is also out for Calvert Hall. That's why we are seeing a little bit of a different offense.
Oh my gosh. That shot was blocked by Johnson. Sorry, Jordan Beck blocked that shot, and it will be McDonough ball with 14 seconds left to go.
Yeah, that was a great job by Jordan Beck to step in front of that shot and block it. And Stengel picking up the loose change.
And that shot will be wide left with 3.6 seconds left to go. All McDonough can really do is, you know, get this ball in, pass it in. Hopefully somebody gets there.
Yeah,
a lot of picks. And nothing will come out of that last 3 seconds. So only two goals this quarter. One for each side, and so we will see you all in the fourth quarter.
And we are back for the fourth and final quarter between your Calvert Hall Cardinals and McDonough Eagles. Jackson Strickland at the faceoff for Calvert Hall going up against Paul McLucas, the LSM. McDonough having trouble at the faceoff lately, and they're going to have to put an LSM
in. There's going to be a flag that comes out. And one of the coaching staff members got on the other side of that hit and came down really, really hard.
And Calvert Hall is going to get another man-up possession here. Josh Nagy using that speed and getting that ground ball. Yeah, that penalty is going to be on Johnny Cool, as we said. Experienced a little bit of technical difficulties on the broadcast. We were sorry about that, but should be back and rolling as best as we can have it. Truett Sunderland with the ball right now. Skip pass to Botek here. Back to Provost.
And it is all even.
And a close no call there. It was a big, looked like a big slash to the face mask, to Provost's face mask, but it's going to be a no call, and we're all even with 32 seconds to go on the shot clock.
And Botek from distance, it'll be saved by Anthony Wilson.
And another save from Wilson. This is a three goal game, but still pretty close, as there's going to be an errant pass, and Jordan Beck's going to pick up that loose change. Calvert Hall might look to push it on offense, but they're going to decide to hold the ball.
Oh, and there's a shot. Provost with the goal, assisted by Johnson. No angle for Provost, and somehow he fit it through, and it is now a two goal game.
Great job there for the Calvert offense. Provost, second goal, hesitating to maybe get that offensive possession going, but did a great job. Like we said, pretty much no angle. Known for making those shots, though. Made one earlier today, and there's going to be a false start against Calvert Hall, and it's going to be McDonough ball. And as we said, the lead now down to 2-7-5. McDonough with 10 minutes and 22 seconds to go in this game. Calvert Hall having a lot of success tonight on these transitions, getting goals. We saw one earlier from Donovan Lewis, who is playing D-mid at the moment. And Bradley Johnson pushing the ball on offense on that pass transition to give Davis Provost the goal.
Here's Millen. McCabe Millen with three goals tonight. Oh, and there's a doorstep shot. And that's going to be a save from Stengel, as that ball was right on the crease.
Stengel is just playing really well. Going to try and save the ball here, but Millen's going to pick it up.
Another save from Stengel. Johnson was trying to run him down, and Stengel comes up big again.
Great to see from the Calvert Hall freshman. And that chewed a lot of time off the shot clock there for McDonough, and they're going to have not as much time to work with now. Only 37 seconds to go. Big double team here, and a great job by Donovan Lewis to cause that turnover, and he's going to push it up the field now.
Sunderland with the goal! And that is a one-goal game. Lewis pushing it up the field, gets it over to Sunderland, and the All-American puts it in. And this game now, Calvert Hall at a one-goal deficit.
What a comeback right now Calvert Hall is having. Still one-goal game, still plenty of time. They're going to have to get another goal to tie this up, but definitely made it interesting and have come back from the depths. And great job by Donovan Lewis. Great double team there. And Donovan Lewis getting another assist on the transition. There's going to be a hold against McDonough. And Calvert Hall is going to get this ball right back and pick up right where they started from. Cody Collier back in now for Calvert Hall. As you said, Truett Sunderland, the All-American, showing that All-American talent with a clutch goal there to make it a one-goal deficit. Calvert Hall's going to have to be careful and make sure they keep playing their game on offense, but not make any silly mistakes. As there's a turnover there, unlucky. Good check from McDonough to cause that turnover.
And Nick Steele just gets the ball poked out. And just unfortunate for Steele. And McDonough has to get it over. They're going to get it over just in time with 1 second to spare.
There's 7 minutes now. 7 minutes and 40 seconds to go in this fourth quarter. Still a one-goal game. And you hear the Calvert Hall fan base, Calvert Hall fans chanting for this defense, giving some life back to this Calvert Hall team.
Great defense.
Yeah, Burley not really having anything there against Josh Nagy. Nagy, the Navy commit for lacrosse.
And this is the matchup. Millen on Kelly. Kelly looking good. And that's a goal for Millen. What a finish from McCade Millen for his fourth goal. And really thought Calvert Hall was playing spectacular defense. And Millen comes up big for McDonough.
It was still pretty good defense by Calvert Hall. Unlucky. Hard when you got one of the, well, the best player in the class of 2023. Getting that fantastic goal, making it a two-goal game now, 8-6. Still plenty of time left in this game, still very close. And they're going to keep Jackson Strickland at the faceoff, as well as Zach Hayashi for McDonough. And Jackson's going to push it back to himself and look to hang on to this ball, and he will. And Calvert Hall is going to start up their offense. Noah Brannick looking to push it forward.
So 6:20 left to go in the final quarter of action. Calvert Hall with 40 seconds on the shot clock. Down 8-6 to McDonough. And Hoddle gonna try and get it inside. He does. Shots. And a huge save for Wilson as he has come up big with now into double digits.
Yeah, that was a fantastic ball movement from the Cardinals. Getting it to Provost on the left side for his lefty shot, but as Trent was said, a great save coming from Wilson. A clutch save late in this fourth quarter. And McDonough's going to slow it down here, maybe chew a little bit of time off the clock and set a proper offense up here to stretch their lead to 3.
On a move from Millen, and it's saved by Stengel again.
Stengel also having a great game, really stepping up as a freshman. And no matter how the outcome turns out for this game, this Calvert Hall team's going to be glad they have him and proud of him for his performance so far. Still plenty of time left. 4 minutes and 40 5 seconds to go. And five offensive players in right now for Calvert Hall. Jordan Ray getting out of trouble, hanging on to that ball. Excuse me, five offensive players, as there's going to be a turnover there, but Calvert Hall is going to pick that ball up, and who else but Truett Sunderland, the All-American, with that clutch ground ball. And there's going to
be a flag.
Big flag.
Ray just made a leap over the crease and just got drilled.
Tough play, though. Great job. Great effort from Jordan Ray. Not fazed at all by that play. And Calderall is going to look to get a goal here on this man-up possession. They've been pretty successful so far tonight on this man-up offense. And
so it'll be a 30-second penalty against Chase Green, the sophomore. And Calvert Hall now man up.
Yeah, it was an interesting series of events there. Calvert Hall only had five players on offense, taking E.J. Vasile out. Wasn't sure if there was a...
They did have six. Lewis was on the near side. It was very hard to see him with the white jerseys and everything. And that shot, no good from Sunderland. 9 seconds left on the penalty.
And 39 seconds left in the shot clock. E.J. Vasile is going to bring it out, and they're going to look to move this ball really quick to maybe try and beat the penalty.
The penalty now released. And shot from Ray, no good. And McDonough now are going to be able to set up their traditional defense.
And Truett Sunderland coming around cage. Going to give a big skip pass there. And Wyatt Hoddle is going to look to take this shot. And he gets a goal!
Gets it. And Wyatt Hoddle with his second, and cuts it to one for Calvert Hall with 3:14 left to go.
Doing it all by himself right there. Saw an opening, got the bouncer between the legs of Wilson, and we are back to a one-goal deficit with 3 minutes and 14 seconds to go. 8-7 now. McDonough still up by one, and they're going to keep the same face-off guys for both teams, and Jackson Strickland's going to get it out to Johnson, and he's going to look to clear this ball up the field, and he will get a successful clear here, and as Jackson Strickland will pass the ball off to Donovan Lewis. And Cody Collier back in now. Still 2 minutes and 40 seconds to go. Cody Collier with the ball now. Doing a lot of fancy moves there, confusing the defense.
And here's Nagy. And now Ray. Ray is there, and they're going to call it a crease violation, and it will be McDonough ball. Calvert Hall needs a little sense of urgency. With only 2:20 left to go, Ray trying to make it happen. I think tripped up a little bit. Oh, and that ball could not be caught by Jones. I think he lost it in the light.
And that is great for Calvert Hall now. They're going to call a timeout, and this Calvert Hall team and fans are fired up. One-goal game now. McDonough up 8-7 with 2 minutes and 12 seconds to go. Calvert Hall is going to set up an offensive possession here. And Calvert Hall will try and get this game all tied up.
Coming into this game, doing, you know, the research is, you know, every, you know, commentators have to do. Was reading about the game against St. Mary's that McDonough had
on the last Tuesday or Tuesday this week, and their coach Andy Hillgartner was saying in the Sun paper that you're not going to be able to win MIAA games with by only scoring six goals as they did in that St. Mary's game. So I really think his goal is to keep a more up-tempo offense, and I just don't know if he's really put that into the game plan today.
Yeah, Calvert Hall definitely keeping an up-tempo offense right now. They are fired up right now, as well as the fans, and Calvert Hall going to look to capitalize here on this offensive possession. Have been having technical difficulties with the broadcast tonight.
The HDMI cord is giving us a little bit of trouble. And Provost cannot get it to go. Under 2 minutes
and
of action left.
They'll look to save this. And Jordan Ray will save that. And
still a loose ball.
Get the ground
Ray
ball.
Gets it.
And they will call a timeout. And Calvert Hall is going to stay with the possession. What an effort by Jordan Ray and Truett Sunderland to keep that ball in bounds.
And Calvert Hall calls that timeout with a minute 42 left and 51 seconds on the shot clock. You know, they have time. They have time, and they're going to set up a play and really go to their, you know, go-to man. So we'll see. We'll see who that is. I think, yeah, Truett, one of those guys is probably Truett Sunderland. Also, Wyatt Hoddle with two goals tonight. Provost with two goals tonight. You know, most of their attack does have, you know, is on the board with a goal. The only, like, one to really notice is E.J. Vasil. But coming in about halfway through the season has had some trouble with injury, so.
Yeah, we'll so still a minute 42 left in the game. Jordan Ray is going to start with the ball. 51 seconds left on the shot clock, and he's going to bring it out for the Cardinals, and they're ready to start up this offense. Going to have a pick early. Look to move this defense around and find any openings. Hopefully, I would think for them to have an opening on the crease for a on-the-crease shot. But as we know, players like Wyatt Hoddle and Truett Sunderland have had plenty of success tonight from outside 10.
So 20 seconds. Jordan gets it to go! And it ties it up. Jordan Ray ties it at 8 with a minute 11 left to go.
What a great effort by Jordan Ray. Jordan Ray with a great effort. Bouncer to the very top left corner and has just brought this Calvert Hall team back to life. And it is now all tied up 8-8 with about a minute and 11 seconds to go. And this fan base is hyped as Calvert Hall is going to get possession, and Bradley Johnson's going to bring it down. And just a missed shot, so close, as Nick Steele will pick it up. And this Calvert Hall Stadium is fired up right now.
And I think if Johnson would have hit that shot, I think this stadium would have gone nuts.
Yeah, it would have been pretty crazy here at Kelly Field. And as you can hear, the fans, they are cheering loud for this Calvert Hall team. Going to look to maybe get a last-minute goal. They got plenty of time. Don't have to worry about the shot clock with 30 seconds to go. It's about a 10-second difference and between shot clock and game clock. And 20 seconds to go now. And who else? Truett Sunderland going to look to maybe get something going here.
Sunderland with the goal!
With 14 seconds left to go, Truett Sutherland with the sidearm shot gets it to go.
Wow, what?
And now Calvert Hall up 9-8. Wow.
Calvert Hall was down 7-3 at the beginning of the third quarter, and they have come back to get this lead, their first lead of the game, 9-8, with 14.4 seconds to go. And who else did you expect? The Under Armour All-American, top five player in the country, Truett Sutherland, getting a clutch goal, and Jackson Strickland's going to look to push it forward here, and he does. Zach Hayashi's going to get the ball, but it's going to be loose ball, and Johnny Cool's going to lose it as Donovan Lewis will pick up the ball, run out the clock, and Calvert Hall is going to come back to win this game 9-8 as players and fans will storm the field, beating their rivals, the McDonough Eagles, 9-8. What an absolute terrific game, and what an effort by Donovan Lewis there at the end to get that ground ball. And what a win. As you can see, maybe here, Trentler and I are in awe of the performance tonight. What a great job by this Calvert Hall team, led by who else but Truett Sutherland.
I mean, it's just so surreal. It's just so surreal. The atmosphere here right now, the students storming the field, fans going crazy tonight. So many fans in attendance, even on spring break. Student section not in full attendance, but doesn't matter. Calvert Hall comes back from that 7-3 deficit and scores, countless goals just unanswered.
Just such a great job there by this Calvert Hall team, and especially give it to the goalie Stangle, freshman Brady Stangle, for stepping up and filling a big role in the cage and getting a lot of saves. And what a game. What a job, great job by the defense, and of course Truett Sutherland, the All-American, getting that clutch goal, and Donovan Lewis ending this game with that clutch ground ball and seeing that wide receiver football speed running it all the way out to the win. Great job by the Cardinals, and great effort by the Eagles as well.
Yeah, and I mean, Wyatt Hoddle with a fantastic game with two goals, Truett Sutherland with two goals, Nick Steele with one, Donnie Lewis. I mean, I think he played one of his best games of the year.
Easily one of his best games, just all over the place, causing turnovers and getting key ground balls in that key goal for this game. So,
yeah, and a lot of players that we normally wouldn't see on the Calvert Hall side getting assists today, Lewis being one of them, then Brannick, and then Bradley Johnson. So just all around spectacular game from this Cardinal team. And as you were saying, Stangle, really came up clutch for them with the absence of Luca Mercaldo.
Yeah, and just great job all around. And this is exactly what this Calvert Hall team needed, coming off of two tough losses. And they are not fazed, and they are showing that they're still here, and you should not forget about who this team is and what they can do. So great effort by this team, and what a comeback. Easily going to be one of the best games of the year, if not the game of the year. So great effort by the Cardinals.
And a statement game for Calvert Hall tonight. So happy that they came away with the win and the comeback. Just spectacular by both sides. Calvert Hall coming away with the win. So I think that'll do it for us tonight for this lacrosse game. So I'm Brennan Trentler alongside Ethan Mers, and have a good night, everyone.